Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about productive cultivation and secondary agriculture, and I am going to cover the topic bucket elevator, which is the third part of the material handling equipments. So I am going to give a short intro about the bucket elevator. So it is the only equipment used in the handling of material conveying in the vertical direction. So the other material handling equipments are only used for the conveying of material in the horizontal direction. So bucket elevator is the only equipment which uses to transfer one material to another point in the upper end in vertical direction is bucket elevator. So while seeing about the bucket elevator, it used to move the belt with the two flat pulleys and a series of buckets to be arranged in a belt. And so the grains in the upper movement, the upper and the discharge at the top due to the centrifugal force produced by the nature. And so the grains from the bucket is said to be pulled down in the discharge end. And the capacity of the elevator majorly depends upon the size of the bucket or cup and also the speed of operation. So a bucket elevator used to be attached in the chain or belt is all on two pulleys, one at the top and other at the bottom. And the vertical lift of the elevator range between few meters to 50 meter. So greater than 50 meter, it used to cause more damage to the material. So up to 50 meter, the bucket elevator is said to be allowed. And also a capacity of bucket elevators may vary from 2 to 10,000 tons per hour. So based on the size of cup as well as the speed of operation taken by the bucket. So it's how the capacity of the bucket elevator is said to be calculated. And the bucket elevator is broadly classified into two types: spaced bucket elevators and the second one is continuous bucket elevators. So first I am going to explain about the spaced bucket elevators. So where the buckets are said to be spaced from one to another. So the major types in spaced bucket elevators are centrifugal discharge elevators, positive discharge elevators, marine leg elevators and high speed elevators. And the second one is continuous bucket elevators, so which is said to be classified into two types. And the buckets are said to be classified and the distance between each them is said to be minimum than spaced one. And the first two, their classifications are super capacity bucket elevators and internal discharge bucket elevators. So the spaced bucket centrifugal discharge type is mostly common in for elevating the grains in most of the industries. So and now we can able to see about their efficiency as well as the limits in this one. So the bucket elevator is efficiently used for vertical conveyance of the bulk grains, and they are also mainly employed in food industries for the vertical conveyance of off grains and derivatives and flows, and also mounting at an affixed location so they can be able to mount it in a mobile frame. So it's how the separation of dust particle from these grains and some other material can be done. And bucket elevators have capacities, and it also used to require horizontal space and operations of conveyance enclosed in housing, and it also said to be dust free and fairly quiet enough. And they also have a wear and tear problem since the product is enclosed in buckets. The flow, so the wear and tear problem can be limited by using the bearings as well as the suitable belt and buckets for the particular crop. And the product flow discharge either by means of gravity or centrifugal force of the material. So it is the picture of bucket elevator. So you must need to remember that the bucket elevator used to have 10 most important parts present in them. The first one is boot take up, and second one is boot assembly, and the third one is inlet where the material is said to be poured down, and the fourth one is inspect door, and the fifth one is middle casing. So inspect door is nothing but it used to prevent the material in the bucket for its overweighting. If the bucket gets overweighted, it they are not able to lift it in the belt. So inspect door is said to be placed in the input end. And so the fifth one is middle casing, and the sixth one is bucket, and the seventh one is chain or belt, and the eighth one is discharge port where the material is said to be pulled down due to the centrifugal force or gravitational force, and the ninth one is pulley socket, and the tenth one is head casing. So it's how the bucket elevator used to work. And we can able to calculate the centrifugal force of the material. So we can able to calculate it by the centrifugal force is equal to WV square divided by GR. So the informations of the W is weight of the grain, V is equal to velocity of the product or mass meter per second, and G is the acceleration due to gravity in that particular area, and R is the radius of the wheel plus one half of the projection of the bucket. So these are the explanation for the symbols which was present in the centrifugal force formula. And so the next one is capacity of the conveyor. So capacity can be calculated by capacity divided by hour into meter in density divided by 1000. It's how the capacity of the conveyor is calculated. And so the we can able to calculate the theoretical value of the bucket elevator by means of the formula where 6p v small v divided by s into 10 power 3 kilogram per hour. It's how the quantity of the theoretical capacitance of the conveyor is said to be calculated. So I have given the lecture notes in description. So comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. If you like the video, like it and share it to your friends and subscribe to BC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.